Okay, so now I'm reading from Shakti, Shakta, The World as Power, by Sir John Woodruff, the late Sir John Woodruff, pen name Arthur Avalon. As I listen to Hari Narayana, blissful, blissful, blissful bhajan, awesome bhajan, provided by the bless forever. Veda. Veda means simply to know. Anta means within. Vedanta means to know within. It is a fundamental error to regard this Vedanta as simply a speculative metaphysic knowledge in the modern Western sense. It is not so. If it were, it would have no greater right to acceptance than any other of the many systems which jostle one another for our custom in the philosophical fair. It claims that its supersensual teachings can be established with certainty by the practice of its methods. Theorizing alone is not sufficient. The Shakta, above all, is a practical and active man, worshipping the divine activity. His watchword is Kriya. Kriya means action, but realized action. Taught that he is power, Ashe, Shakti. He desires fully to realize himself as such. A tantric poem speaks with amused disdain of the learned chatterers who pass their time in futile debate around the shores of the lake of doubt. The basis of knowing, whether supra-sensual knowing or mere sense knowledge, is actual experience. Whether you can prove it or not. Experience, then, is of two kinds. The whole, or full experience, and, of course, incomplete experience, that is, of parts, not of, but in, the whole. In the first experience, consciousness is said to be upward-looking, Unmukhi, because mukhi, mukha means face. Upward looking, that is, not looking to another. In the second experience, it is outward looking, bahir mukhi. Bahir means out, mukhi face, outward looking. The first is not an experience of the whole, but the experience whole itself. The second is an experience not of parts of the whole, for the latter is partless, but of parts in the whole, and issuing from its infinite power to know itself in and as the finite centers, as the many. The works of an Indian philosopher, Professor Pramatanatha Mukhyopadhyaya, aptly called the first the fact, and the second the fact section. The Isha Upanishad calls the supreme experience Purna, the full or whole. It is not, be it noted, a residue of the abstracting intellect, which is itself only a limited stress in consciousness, but a plenum complete, in which the existent all is as one whole. theologically, this full experience is Shiva, with Shakti at rest or as potency. The second experience is that of the finite centers, the numerous Purushas or Jivas, which are also Shiva-Shakti, as potency actualized. Both experiences are real. In fact, there is nothing unreal anywhere. All is the Mother, and she is reality itself. Saham, she I am, the Shakta says, and all that he senses is she in the form in which he perceives her. It is she who in and as he drinks the consecrated wine, and she is the wine. All is manifested power, which has the reality of being from which it is put forth. But the reality of the manifestation is of something which appears and disappears, while that of causal power to appear is enduring. But this disappearance is only the ceasing to be for a limited consciousness. The seed of power which appears as a thing for such consciousness remains as the potency, an infinite being itself. The infinite experience is real as the full, purna, that is, its reality is fullness. The finite experience is real as such. There is perhaps no subject in Vedanta which is more misunderstood than that of the so-called unreality of the world. Again and again and again I salute Mahanarayana. Mahanarayana, by whose grace I will return home again one day. Om Namo Narayanaya. Om Namo Narayanaya. Om Namo Narayanaya. Thank you, my friends, for allowing me to share this moment of gravity.